What's up, peers, and welcome to Bitcoin to the Max here on the World Crypto Network. And today, let's discuss a little bit what Gresham's Law actually is and how it might or might not apply to Bitcoin. Well, as usual, I do believe that the gold coin analysis is quite useful, as gold is similar in many ways to Bitcoin. When you have a gold coin containing precisely 1 ounce of gold, and you know the money base is the gold atoms, so you know exactly how many gold atoms are in this one gold coin, precisely 1 ounce of. And of course, this will mean that the gold coin itself will be worth 1 ounce. You can trade goods and services with the value that the other participant in the trade sees that this 1 ounce has. And of course, then in a free society, if you would start clipping away at the edges and removing a bit of the gold dust of this coin, so that the total weight would be only 0.9 ounces of gold, what would happen? Well, in a free society, of course, the other partner would see, hey, this is not 1 ounce, this is 0.9 ounces. Thus, I will only give you goods and services that I want to exchange for 0.9 ounces of gold, of money base. Of course, this might take a little, right, if you only skip off a little bit of the gold coin and have 0.99 ounces. Nobody might know or recognize that there is less money in this gold coin. But after all, it is possible, right? And then further, how does Gresham's Law apply in this sense? And important is here to realize that Gresham's Law only arises under government coercion and force and aggression. And this is specifically when there is one government saying that this gold coin we imprint, we mint, to be valued at 1 ounce of gold. And if there's 1 ounce of gold in the gold coin, then well, everything is fine, right? You can exchange it for worth of 1 ounce of goods and services. But here, when you start clipping away at the edges of the coins, and all of a sudden you only have 0.9 ounces of gold, well, the face of the coin has not changed. It is still at 1 ounce, at least the face value. And if you're legally forced to, or aggressed against, to accept this one, the 0.9 ounce gold coin as 1 ounce, well, then you lose, right? Because you have to give more goods and services for less money. So in this sense, the merchant is losing. He's actively being stolen from, of course, under government coercion and aggression. And now you, as a user of this money, you have two gold coins. One that is actually filled with 1 ounce of gold, and the other one that is filled with 0.9 ounces of gold. But because of legal tender, both have to be accepted by the merchants for the equal amount of goods and services. And this means that you are incentivized to hold back the 1 ounce gold coin, right, which is the full face value and the most base money is in this gold 1 ounce gold coin. And you spend the 0.9 ounce gold coin because for less amount of money, for less amount of gold, you receive the same amount of goods and services. So it makes sense for you to hold the artificially undervalued money and spend the artificially overvalued money. And the artificial part is solely because of government aggression and violence. So when we say that Gresham's Law is, it means that artificially overvalued money, the 0.9 ounce gold coin, will drive out of the market artificially undervalued money, which is the full 1 ounce gold coin. Okay, so in that sense, bad money drives out good money, but only under government aggression. Now, how does this apply in Bitcoin? Because, well, one Bitcoin is one Bitcoin. And there is no government edict saying that you have to accept 0.9 ounces or 0.9 Bitcoin, 90 million Satoshis, to be the same as 100 million Satoshis, one Bitcoin. There is no government coercion and violence accepted or present in the pure Bitcoin economy. There is the relentless free market and free individuals engaging in mutually beneficial voluntary exchange. And this means, of course, that when you spend one Bitcoin, you get goods and services worth for that amount. And if you spend 0.9 Bitcoin, well, you get less goods and services. And you cannot force the merchant to trade more goods and services for less Bitcoin, because that will be aggression and wrong. So there is no Gresham's Law in the Bitcoin economy. However, there is government aggression and violence in the fiat realm. You are being forced to use the euro shitcoin or the US dollar shitcoin, at least for paying debts and taxes, which again is theft itself. So then on the other hand, there is the US dollar or euro is artificially overvalued. It is the good that you have to use, and you know, it is thus artificially overvalued. It is worth more than it otherwise would be. In a free market, no one would use the US dollar shitcoin. Like, I would prefer Ripple to that shitcoin, seriously. Probably not Ripple, but at least Dogecoin, okay? And Dogecoin is not a shitcoin. And then this means that we have a artificially overvalued money, the US dollar shitcoin, and a artificially undervalued money, the Bitcoin sound money. And this means that market participants are incentivized to hold, to retain, to hodl their precious Satoshis, because it's the truly valued sound money, artificially undervalued though. And on the other hand, you're incentivized to spend the fiat shitcoin, because it is artificially overvalued. And that is why we don't see yet massive merchant adoption and Bitcoin being used as everyday payment. Why? Because you are incentivized to hold your Bitcoin and spend your fiat. And this Gresham's Law, that the artificially overvalued money, fiat, drives out artificially undervalued money, Bitcoin, means that you spend fiat and hodl Bitcoin. But where does this end? Well, at that moment where you give away your last fiat shitcoin and all you have left are precious Satoshis, then that's it. You've successfully exited coercive and violent markets such as the fiat shitcoin markets, and you are now in the pure state of freedom and monetary self-sovereignty. And at that point, you will eventually have to spend your precious Bitcoin to buy your goods and services that you need and that you desire, which is, of course, good. But at that point, your time preference has also adjusted to not spend your money on worthless plastic crap, but actually spend it for the goods and services that you truly need and desire, and that will help you to increase your productivity in the future. So Gresham's Law does apply between fiat and Bitcoin, and it stops at that point where you have gotten rid of all the fiat bags. Pierce, thank you very much here for joining me on Bitcoin to the Max on the World Crypto Network. And as usual, you can get early access to these shows on teleco.in/hillebrandmax. And also, there is a way for you to ask questions that I can then go into in depth and talk about whatever you want me to talk about. Pierce, as usual, thank you for watching and see you on the next show. Bye-bye.